Hi, my name's Lydia and I'm 15. Over the next few weeks, all young people aged 12 to 15 will be offered the COVID-19 vaccine. This is a big deal, particularly as there is a lot of misinformation online and on social media. The purpose of this video is to give you all the facts you need to make an informed choice about whether you want to have the COVID-19 vaccine. I'm here today with Chief Nurse Vic to talk about the COVID-19 vaccine so you can all have a greater understanding of what it is. So, Vic, jumping straight in, why are 12 to 15-year-olds being asked to have the COVID vaccine when I thought the number of young people getting COVID was low?
So one of the reasons for offering the vaccine to 12 to 15-year-olds is we know through the evolution of virus spread that the more people that get the vaccine, then we reduce the chance of it spreading further across the community. One of the important things to remember is by having the vaccine not only protects you, but also protects your family and the community.
Great, thank you. And will the vaccine stop young people from getting COVID-19?
So what the vaccine does is it reduces the likelihood of you getting COVID-19 and less likely again to be admitted to hospital.
And if, say, I don't have the vaccine and get COVID-19, as a young person, what's the worst thing that could happen?
So one of the things that we do know and we have learned is that if you've not been vaccinated, you're much more likely to be admitted to hospital and experience more serious side effects from the virus. And this can actually result in individuals developing long COVID, which means side effects that last a long time.
And if, say, a young person's already had COVID-19, do they still need the vaccine?
Yes, definitely. So one of the things that we don't quite know as yet is how long the immunity lasts if you catch COVID. And we know that it's more likely to last longer if you're vaccinated.
So moving on to talking about the actual vaccine, what vaccine will younger people have and how many doses will we need?
So at the moment, we're offering younger people the Pfizer vaccine and we're offering one dose at the moment. But we are offering two doses to those who live with either somebody who's very vulnerable or they themselves are clinically vulnerable.
And how come young people are only having one dose when adults are having two or three?
The more people have one dose, then it reduces the transmission of COVID-19. So that's a really positive step. And obviously this is something that will be continually reviewed.
And are there any side effects when we have the vaccine?
So not everyone experiences side effects. And some people report for a couple of days after they've had the vaccine, they have a heavy or sore arm, a mild headache, and a feeling of fatigue, which normally only lasts a couple of days. And it's important to say that those side effects are less than actually if you were to contract COVID-19.
And can you catch COVID-19 from having the vaccine?
No, you can't catch COVID from having the vaccination, no.
Good, thank you. And I know for a lot of young people, the idea of having a vaccination can be quite painful and nerve-wracking. So would you say to those young people, does the vaccine hurt? Is it worth the mild discomfort you might go through for the greater cause?
Yeah, the vaccine is no dissimilar to other vaccinations that 12 to 15-year-olds would have had or other vaccinations have had within the school setting. So it doesn't hurt any more than any other vaccination. And the side effects are minimal and not everybody will experience the side effects. So I definitely encourage people to have the vaccine.
Perfect, thank you. I'm sure that will put a lot of young people at ease who are a bit concerned. Where will we be having the vaccine and who's going to be administering the vaccine?
So at the moment it's part of a really big rollout programme that we're going to be vaccinating 12 to 15-year-olds within schools. So that's what we're currently working on at the moment. So you would be offered the vaccination within your school setting. And for those children who are not at school, we are working up a plan to ensure that they get vaccinated as well. But our first target is schools.
And is it our choice or decision or our parents' choice to have the vaccine?
So it's one of those things we hope is a bit of a joint decision between your decision and your parents. So we actually send the invite to you and encourage you to discuss it with your parents to get consent. We do ask for written consent from parents as well, so parental consent. However, if somebody comes to the vaccine area and are quite convinced that they want to have the vaccine, then we will do everything we can to try and get verbal consent from a parent.
What would happen, say, if a young person's parent or carers says yes, but the young person, say, doesn't want the vaccine?
So that's something then we would speak to the young person and just try to understand what it is that is making them not want the vaccine. And then we've got very specially trained nurses who are within the school and who they can talk to, or they can seek, you know, a bit more advice and support. And hopefully we can kind of demystify some of their fears.
What if a young person misses the vaccine in school and at age 12, 15, can they have it somewhere else?
Yeah, so we're currently looking at those plans as we speak at the moment to either have second dates within schools so that we can actually return to schools and do the young people that we didn't get the opportunity to vaccinate. But in the early stages of this programme, we really want people to have it, younger people to have it within the school.
If a young person has tested positive for COVID-19, say in the past month or week, will that stop them from having the vaccination?
So we don't recommend that the younger person would have the vaccination. We normally recommend about a month after you've had tested positive for COVID. But again, that depends on how the younger person might be feeling. So what we have got is a kind of question and answer leaflet that we circulate. And it's got the specific details of what to do if somebody had COVID-19 but still wants to be vaccinated, but it's in too short a time scale.
For those 16 to 17-year-olds who are not involved in this 12 to 15-year-old bracket, where can they have the vaccine?
So they're really in a great position now. So they can go to either a local pharmacy or one of the big vaccination hubs, and there's lots of those across South West London, so they can access the vaccine that way. So it's really easy for them to get the vaccine.
A lot of young people will still be wondering what the point in getting the vaccine is. So what's one thing you would say to us to convince us to have the jab?
We really need young people to have the jab. It's really beneficial because it will help us stop the spread of this virus, and we need the young people to do that. And this isn't just for the young person themselves. This is about their family, their friends, and the people they live in their local community. And to be honest with you, you know, being unwell with COVID-19 is not good, and you know, people can be seriously unwell. And on top of that, be isolating and have to stay at home. We want to get back to normal. So we really need young people to help us do that.
You've heard it here, people. We need to get the COVID-19 vaccine. Thank you so much for watching. And thank you, Chief Nurse Nick, for spending time with me to share the truth about the vaccine. I hope that this has been helpful to the young people watching. And if you still have any questions, please make sure you look at the professional websites like the NHS, or follow the links on the screen below. It is so clear, as young people, we need to come together, get the COVID-19 vaccine to not only protect ourselves, protect our family members, friends, and the local community. Thank you.